I have been asked to introduce a eminent personality which requires no introduction. In fact, he is very popularly known in the country as well as an internationally renowned figure. He is most respected in his profession. He is the winner of many awards. I feel highly proud to introduce him. He is none other than Padma Shri Professor Dr. Jagat Ram, an eminent ophthalmologist and is head advanced eye center and director of Postgraduate Institute of Medical Education. He received the Oscar of Pediatric Ophthalmology at the World Congress at Pediatric Ophthalmology Strasbourg in Barcelona. He assumed the office of director at PGIMER in March 2017. He was conferred Padma Shri Award by the President of India in January 2019. In 2020, he has completed 41 years in the PGIMER. Sir, now I humbly request you to kindly deliver your keynote.
Yeah, thank you very much. I think it was excellent, outstanding keynote address by Professor Radhika Tandon. I know her for the last more than 30 years or so. She does outstanding work in this field, and I think no person is better than her, particularly in this field. And Dr. Rakesh Gupta, President and Director, PH Cypher, Professor Sonu Goyal from Community Medicine, Dr. Ashok Sharma, Dr. Professor Shakin Singh, Professor Karamjit Singh, Dr. Rohit Gupta, Dr. Ramesh, and friends. First of all, I would like to congratulate Dr. Rakesh Gupta and Professor Sonu Goyal for organizing this webinar for celebrating this virtual eye donation fortnight. This year, the eye donation fortnight is last year. It started on 25th of August and continued till 8th of September. In our country, the magnitude, as already said by Professor Radhika Tandon, magnitude of corneal blindness is very high, and few millions people have unilateral corneal blindness, and as many as 1.1 million people are blind due to corneal involvement, and they are waiting for keratoplasty, and there is only I think 30 to 40,000 keratoplasty each year, and additional 25 to 30,000 people are added to this backlog. Like the previous year, we could not organize the eye donation walk and series of lecture in the school and different location due to COVID pandemic 19. But we organize a webinar and a video competition, painting competition for eye donation this year. It has also resulted in a marked decrease in the actual donation of the eyes. But recently, due to the help of forensic medicine here in PGI, we could get a few dozens of the eye from the medical legal cases. But that was after following a proper procedure. I think very rightly said by Dr. Radhika Tandon that it is a teamwork. This is not just a single individual work, and where we need doctor, social worker, technical staff, and public involvement. And very rightly said that we have to focus on the rural area, particularly for the preventive aspect, and the hospital, particularly the urban area for hospital retrieval program. There are a lot of superstition. I think we need not even tell, because people think that after in the next birth one may be blind. I think it is not right. There is a tremendous need to increase the eye donation in our country, which is possible in several ways. Every one of us can pledge to donate eyes, and irrespective of the age, sex, or even in presence of comorbidity, whether you are hypertensive or diabetic, or whether you are emetropic, myopic, or hypermetropic. Key to success for eye donation is increase in the awareness, campaign, and engagement of the community, which is very, very crucial. I think today I urge you, all of you, to pledge for eye donation as well as for organ donation. We have to motivate other to pledge for eye donation as well as motivate the actual for actual eye donation at the time of death. We here in PGI, we take every patient wherever we receive the eye during this period. We take the sample and do the real-time RT-PCR or gene expert. Also the other routine test, what we take from the blood for whether it is HIV or hepatitis. That is whatever we use previously. In addition, we are doing real-time PCR wherever we are taking, because you cannot presume anybody that he may be negative. So we have to rule out whether he is COVID positive or negative. So again, because I will not go long way, and once again, I thank Dr. Rakesh Gupta and Professor Sonu Goel for organizing this webinar on occasion of conclusion of 35th Eye Donation Fortnight 2020. I conclude reiterating my commitment to the cause of eye donation with the slogan Netradan Mahadan, Angdan Mahadam. Once again, I thank all of you for patience listening. Thank you very much.